We move on to the next presentation by Dr. Janssen. And Dr. Janssen right now is the president of the Dutch Arthroscopy Association. I remember the times that we had common meetings. It's always a pleasure to have our northern brothers down here in Antwerp. So welcome, Dr. Janssen.
Thank you, Professor Verdonken. Thank you for the invitation to be here. Also for the hospitality that has been granted yesterday night and today. Let's see the presentation. Is that... I'm sorry. There we go. Now, as after this excellent surgery, as been shown by Professor Verdonken earlier, what happens to the graft once we put it inside of the knee? We strip it of everything that is vital. In this case, it's a hamstring graft which is used. We move all the muscle tissues and then put it back into the knee and expect it to become a new ACL. Does it? Does it remain viable? Or does it become some kind of fibrous tissue? That's what I'd like to talk about to you today. This is graft remodeling, and we'll compare animal studies to human studies and what we know now in 2013. Small overview of my presentation. I'll start an introduction on the topic. I'll give you the animal data that we have on remodeling and why this is important to know. We'll compare that to the human data, and we'll finish up with some conclusions. Now, as we've been talking about today, successful ACL surgery requires the understanding of anatomic graft placement, wherever the anatomy might be. We need to look at mechanical properties of the graft that we have selected. We've seen some examples today. We'll see some more this afternoon. What fixation method do you use? What are their characteristics? And we need to know what the biological processes are that the graft will undergo after reconstruction. Now, we know that ACL surgical techniques have definitely improved for the last 10 years. We've seen many improvements today in terms of where to find the footprint. But there's still a graft failure prevalence of 10%. And when we talk about healing of an ACL, we can talk about either healing inside of the tunnels, so the femoral or the tunnel, femoral the tibial part of the graft, and we can talk about the intra-articular healing, and that's what I would like to focus on today. And that is what we call remodeling. Now, 1905, Willem Roux, and to state that nothing that is old can still be good, just as this founder just said, an organ, he stated the law of functional adaptation, which says that an organ will adapt itself structurally to an alteration quantitative or qualitative in function. And this would mean if we put a graft at the correct position inside of the knee as an ACL replacement, and we make it submit to correct forces at the various phases of rehabilitation, we expect it to become a tissue like ACL or an intact ACL. And this process of changing tissue has been termed ligamentization by the author who first started doing research on this. Now, what do we know about remodeling in animals, and why is this important? We know that in animal studies, there have been three phases of remodeling. And although remodeling of the graft is a continuous process, each phase has specific characteristics. And these three phases is the early graft healing phase, the proliferation phase, and the ligamentization phase, by some authors also called maturation phase. And it's important to realize that the data that's come from these animal data, from these animal studies, has been extrapolated to translated to the human ACL rehabilitation protocols that you and I use today. So this is the basis of where it comes from. And is it still valid for human rehabilitation if we look at the human studies? We'll get back to that later. Well, let's look at these specific phases. The first phase, the early graft healing phase, takes place the first 4 weeks after reconstruction. And there's necrosis at the graft center. There's very little cellular activity, no signs of revascularization. And the graft itself, in terms of collagen structure and crimp pattern, is not changed. And this has an implication, because if a graft fails at the early stages after reconstruction, it is not because the graft itself ruptures, but there's a failure of the biological graft incorporation in the tunnels, with the risk at the failure and the pullout. And that is why the fixation strength of your components is important, the primary phase of rehabilitation. The second phase is the most active phase of remodeling. It's proliferation. And this occurs between 4 and 12 weeks after reconstruction in animals. And what happens is a lot of cellular activity, myofibroblasts appear, and myofibroblasts are specific fibroblasts for the remodeling process. And they're important to create the in situ tension that is necessary for the later ligamentization or maturation phase. Revascularization occurs from the periphery to the center of the graft. the collagen fibril density decreases, and there's a type 3 collagen synthesis. And as you might know, collagen type 3 is a weaker collagen than type 1. And this will lead to the fact that the graft has its mechanical properties, the weakest point in the remodeling phase, at 6 to 8 weeks. And this animal data has been translated into protocols that we use on humans. But the question is this also valid in humans? Third phase, ligamentization or maturation, between 12 weeks and 12 months in animals. And after a primary increase of cellularity in the second proliferation phase, it now slows down, and it looks like an ACL at 3 to 6 months after surgery. In terms of vascularity, after initial increase in the proliferation phase, the previous phase, the vascularity diminishes and becomes somewhat similar to an ACL at 6 to 12 months. However, the collagen 3 content remains elevated, meaning a weaker graft, and the collagen alignment, although it increases, loses its bimodality. And here's an example of that. And on the right is an intact ACL, and this is a collagen fibril alignment. And you see that there's fibrils of larger and smaller diameter. On the left is a graft 12 months after reconstruction. And although there is a collagen fibril alignment, all the grafts are of the smaller type, so a weaker type. And the structural properties of a graft in animal studies has shown that it's only 50 to 60% in terms of strength compared to your original ACL. Now here's an example of revascularization. Top left is the intact ACL, and this is specific coloring techniques for vascular structures. The proliferation phases at 6 weeks and 12 weeks show an intense revascularization. Then the vascularity diminishes and becomes somewhat similar to what the intact ACL looks like after 1 year. Now in summary, what do we know about graft remodeling in animal studies? There's a restoration of graft integrity and histological appearance at 6 to 12 months. And the morphology is quite similar to the intact ACL. The mechanical properties reach a maximum strength of 12 months after reconstruction, and there's no change thereafter. But the mechanical strength itself is only 50 to 60% of an intact ACL. So how does this relate to humans? And animal studies are important because you can take certain time points after reconstruction. However, there's also limitations to animal studies. Factors that are difficult to control is graft isometricity and anatomical positioning. And you need to realize that the studies that were done on animals were mostly done by arthrotomy, not arthroscopy. And the position was definitely not an anatomical position. Now the other factors, patient compliance, vascularity, biomechanical strength, and of course rehabilitation, are difficult to control in animal studies. But we do know that animal studies are important because the human studies are limited and also have their limitations. And there's two types of studies that have been done in humans on remodeling of grafts. The first is MRI studies, gadolinium enhanced, and they try to focus on vascularity and revascularization of the graft. And although periphery can be shown, the center of the graft, we have very little information. So there's limited values so far of the MRI studies that have been done. And the second type of human studies on remodeling are biopsy studies. Postmortem is one possibility, and most of the studies have looked at second look arthroscopy. And the limitations of second look arthroscopy is the fact that only the periphery of the graft has taken a biopsy off, so we do not know what happens in the center of the graft. And there is also a focus on the later stages of remodeling, because there's very few reasons for a second look arthroscopy in the first few weeks after the reconstruction. Now, what do we know about human versus animal remodeling studies? That the graft in both animal and humans remains viable. So throughout the remodeling process, it does not become fibrous tissue. And they undergo the same three phases of remodeling, but there are some distinct differences. In early graft healing phase, so the first phase, in humans, there is much less graft necrosis than in animals. And that's important because we focused earlier that at 6 to 8 weeks after the reconstruction in animals, the graft was at its weakest. And although we think that in humans it is also the weaker point of the graft remodeling, the integrity of the graft in humans might be a lot stronger than what we have in animal studies. So this might be an adaptation for our rehabilitation protocols. And furthermore, both the proliferation phase and the ligamentization phase are way longer, more extended than in the animal studies. And we do need to realize that we have no idea of the final graft structure properties in humans. It has a clinical value, we know that it functions, but we do not know if it's stronger than the 50-60% of strength that we've seen in animal studies. So I'll show you some examples of the human values and the difference in stages. This is a study that we published in 2011, and where we looked at 67 patients. We did a second look at arthroscopy at 6 to 117 months after a successful reconstruction, stable knees, with a quadruple hamstring and a standardized accelerated rehab protocol. And depending on the time point when the biopsies were taken, we allocated them to one of the three groups, either 6 to 12 months after reconstruction, 1 to 2 years, or over 2 years after reconstruction. And there were two control groups, the hamstring tendon, the remnant after surgery, and native ACLs. And this is what we've looked at, both qualitative and descriptive analysis. And the enjoyable part of its research is we did this at the Charité in Berlin with Andreas Weiler and Sven Scheffler. And they're the ones who did most of the sheep studies on which our rehabilitation protocols have been based. So we use the same colorimetric techniques as they use in animals on the human biopsies. And what we showed is a few of the, show you a few results. So what happens to cells? If you look at cellular density, on the vertical axis is the density of cells, and the horizontal axis are our groups of study, so the three groups of biopsies and the two controls. And you see that from the first group to the second group, there's an increase in cellular density. There's a decrease in due time, but it never reaches the point of cellular density of our controls. So there's a remodeling process that keeps on going. And the same is true for the vascular density. If you look at specific immunohistaining, for vascular structures, the density is here on the vertical axis, horizontal axis, the same groups as previously mentioned. There's also an increase from group 1 to 2, and after 2 years there's a slight decrease, but there's never a point at which the native ACL vascularity is reproduced. And finally, myofibroblast density, as shown, this is very specific for the remodeling process, so if myofibroblasts are present, there's remodeling going on. There's also a factor that plays, by the way, in arthrofibrosis, the myofibroblast activity. And we see that there's an increase from group 1 to 2, a decrease in 3, but never the same point at which the controls are there. So there's still remodeling going on 2 years after the reconstruction. So in conclusions, the human ACL graphs show typical three stages of remodeling. The remodeling process is not finished 2 years after the reconstruction. And the modeling process in humans is elongated compared to the data that we have from animal studies on which our current rehabilitation protocols are based. Now looking at the model of today, the sequel of remodeling, this is what we might look at for the future. I think we need to optimize ACL surgery, as we've been discussing today, to restore anatomy and function while providing the correct mechanical strength of the intact ACL for the law of functional adaptation to take place. We could develop biological treatments that have an impact on the early graft healing, also for the extracellular matrix development, and avoid excessive remodeling that might impair mechanical integrity. And we need to differentiate good from bad remodeling process to optimize rehab for a faster return to unrestricted activity. And for those interested in the latest work on this, these are the three papers that's come out. The top one is soon in KSTA. It's open access and shows all the current knowledge also on MRI studies. And I especially recommend the paper of Stephen Klaus and Peter Verdonk, a review that written 2 years ago as well. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Rob, for this investigation. That's always fascinated me, where we kept to the 6 months and then 12 months and asked people to be careful. And time and again, the same numbers come up. And so I feel like relatively safe. Any questions?